Narcissism and religion. I think the Abrahamic religions, which includes Judaism, Christianity, and Islam, are steeped in narcissism. And I will concentrate on Judeo-Christianity because it's the one I'm most familiar with. And I think it's a very narcissistic religion. What is narcissism? The definition, according to the American Heritage Dictionary, is excessive love or admiration of oneself. The history of the word comes from, it was a god or a goddess. I think it was a god. It was a beautiful youth in mythology who fell in love with his own reflection in a spring and turned into the flower Narcissus. It also comes from the Greek word narc, which means numbness. We also get the word narcotic from the same root. Why do I think Judeo-Christianity is narcissistic? If you listen to the average gospel song, and I'm speaking about African-American gospel music in particular, it's all about me. I'm blessed. I was down, but God made a way for me. But forget everybody else. It's all about me, and God's been good to me. Forget the starving children of the world, who your God did not bless or give a damn about. Listen to the average gospel song, and I'm going to give you an example. It's a song by Walter Hawkins. It was remade by a contemporary gospel group, a duet, Mary Mary. Thank you, Lord, for all you've done for me. And here's the lyrics. Just listen to the lyrics. Tragedies are commonplace. All kinds of diseases, people are slipping away. Economy's down, people can't get enough pay. As for me, all I can say is, thank you, Lord, for all you've done for me. Folks without homes, living out in the streets, and the drug habits some say they just can't beat. Murders and robbers, no place seems to be safe. You've been my protection every step of the way. And I want to say thank you, Lord, for all you've done for me. And the chorus goes, it could have been me. Thank you. Outdoors, thank you. With no food, thank you. No clothes, thank you. Or left alone, thank you. Without a friend, thank you. Or just another number, thank you. With a tragic end, thank you, Lord. But you didn't see fit, thank you. But let none of these things be. Or to let none of these things be, thank you. Because every day your power, thank you. You keep on keeping me, thank you. And all I want to say is thank you, Lord, for all you've done for me. In other words, it's all about me. And this is why the average Judeo-Christian person say God is good. Look at Christianity. It gives the idea of self-importance to the point that God himself took on human flesh and he died just for you. You are so important that he created the entire universe and the earth just for you. Aren't you special? Forget all the other animals and insects and birds, fish and reptiles. They have to fight for their survival, and if they're lucky, they can become your meal. But it's not about them, it's all about you. Because you're so special. And you're so special, which means that if you believe this, that you will have eternal life. And you get to sing in God's special choir and be his choir boy or girl and praise him forever and ever. And it's all about free will, but it's not really free. You got to voluntarily give it up to the will of God. But if you don't, you will roast forever. It's like a mother telling their victim, give me your wallet or I'll shoot. If they have the gun pointed to their head. Is this free will? If you don't believe, you have maggots that will eat on you forever. And your whole life will be played back to you forever and ever. of all the times that you rejected God and how nasty a person you was. This is what, you know, people tell children to get them to get saved, quote unquote saved. But it's all about you. You're special. You're God's special playmate or toy. Yes, I know someone says, what about Christian missionary work who help the poor and sick? You wonder if they're doing it for genuine help or concerned, or are they doing it to get a reward in heaven or a crown in glory in the next life? Plus, in order to get help, you have to listen to their propaganda. It is a selfish religion, for it's all about securing their eternity or their hope of being resurrected after they die. Well, think about it. This is Lee, aka Black Socrates, and I'm out. Peace. Better listen while you can. It's a very thin line between animal and man. When Hannibal crossed the line, they all took a stand. What would you have done? Shook his hand. This is the animal and man. This is the animal and man.